Shalom, ladies and gentlemen. Today we will be talking, as always, about our weekly Torah portion. Our weekly Torah portion called Shoftim, the judges, and Shotrim, the policemen, the guards. And probably this is the closest Torah portion that comes to talk about the Jewish government system. Because we went through all the stages of the creation of the nation according to the philosophers of Age of Enlightenment, from revolution and foundation of the national identity. This was Yetzias Mitzrayim, the exodus from Egypt, then the constitutional period when we received our constitution, Mount Sinai, and now when we're standing at the borderline to the land of, to come to the land of Israel and to create our own state, our own government, we have to decide on the government system. The ancient Greeks, they described many governmental systems: monarchy, anarchy, democracy, tyranny, and so on. So which one is a Jewish one? The obvious answer would be monarchy, because, yes, obviously we're all waiting for the King Mashiach, and if you're waiting for the King Mashiach, we're obviously waiting for the king, and it is, it would be a monarchy. But our weekly Torah portion, yes, it gives us the mitzvah of appointing the king, but on the other hand, Moshe Rabbeinu says very strange things about the king, that he will come and take your children to the army and your daughters to his palace, and will take all your vineyards and your businesses and distribute it among, among his children. And actually, this is the same words that Prophet Shmuel repeats in the first book of Shmuel, when the Jewish people want to appoint the king. He repeats the prophecy of Moshe Rabbeinu. So then the question is, why do we need the king? But the prophecy in the Jewish tradition, it's not a prediction of the future. The prophecy, it's the warning, what could happen, and we will not take the proper action. And this is what Moshe Rabbeinu begins his prophecy and saying, when you will ask to have the king like other nations, then all these prophecies will come to be. And then actually this is what happens, because in the prophet Shmuel, when we talk about the Jewish people that come to the prophet Shmuel and say, Aseh lanu melech kechol ha-goyim, make us a king, appoint us a king like all the nations, Shmuel repeats the Moshe's prophecy, and unfortunately this prophecy came to be in our history. We read about many, many very unpleasant stories about our Jewish kings, even Kings David and King Shlomo, and what we're talking about, Ahab, and later on Hashmonaim. So why do we need the king? Why do we need the king, as if the prophecy said that this how it's going to end up? And actually our sages in their commentaries say that there's not necessarily, some of commentaries say that we have the mitzvah of appointing the king. Ibn Ezra, for example, he says that it's not a mitzvah to appoint the king, it's a simply permission to have a king. But there is no need to this. Only if you decide you want a king, you can have a king. Abarbanel, who was a prominent Republican, not in the American political system understanding, but in the understanding of the governmental system, he said that it was just a historical period when people have kings and it will pass. We will create a new type of governmental system. But the truth is, we not necessarily as a Jewish people need the king, because the answer to this goes in the beginning of our portion. Lubavitch Rebbe explained that the words Shoftim veShotrim, Shotrim titen b'sharecha, that you have to appoint the judges and the guards in your gates, it's directed to us personally, because we all have our personal relationship with God. We living in the God's kingdom. And this is what Yosef Flavius, out of all the scholars, defined as a Jewish governmental system. He coined the term theocracy, the rulership of religion. No, don't think it's a rulership of religion in terms of Pope and or Ayatollah, or even not the chief rabbinate. No, he talks about your personal relationship with God, because we have only one king. This is a Kadosh Baruch Hu. And to make him our king, we have to appoint our own judges and guards in our gates. Lubavitch Rebbe says that your gates, it's your input and output system, how you see things, how you say things, what you hear, what you don't need to hear. And this is why the Parshas Shoftim we always read during the Elul time, when we have to analyze yourself and be extra careful before the judgment day. We have to appoint our own governing system, the governing system of God, our own guards. We have created our own theocracy. And then the structure of the government, of Jewish government, will be here to serve the people in order to serve the God. And the King of Mashiach that we're waiting for, it's not the king that we will worship. It's a kingdom of Mashiach that will help us to serve God in a proper way. You have to create your own personal government for God to rule over you. Good luck. Thank you. See you next week.